Good morning, 714 Tribe. God bless you on this special day as we celebrate together 714 prayer, as well as today is special for every 4 years we inaugurate a new president. And so we have much to be praying for in our land of the free, and we need to continue to focus that God's perfect will would be done, and we just pray God's richest blessings upon the outgoing as well as the incoming president of the United States. And so let's continue to gather together and pray not only for a peaceful transition, but also for that God would bless our nation through their wise decision making. And that leads me to Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3. It's a scripture that I used last year, and I came across it last night, and I thought, wow, this is such a great nugget of wisdom. And it says this: a prudent person foresees danger and takes precautions. The simpleton goes blindly on and suffers the consequences. You know, it's much like if you're driving down the road and you're driving on a bridge and there's a big, huge sign that says bridge out, and you just continue to drive, right? There's no wisdom there. There's absolutely no wisdom because there's no bridge. And so, unfortunately, you're going to fall from the bridge. But a prudent person, a wise person, will see it ahead and take precautions. And think about this for a moment. You can apply that in any part of your life. We know haste makes waste and it slows down, right? It's being wise with our spending. It's in regard to the way we do business. You know, any business owner, even in this moment as a pastor and as a board of your church, with all the things that have changed with the pandemic, we've had to take some and look at some adjustment. We had to use prudency and wisdom on how to manage in this new year based on the different things and the different dynamics that this pandemic has brought to a church. So to be wise means that you foresee it and then you take precautions. But a simpleton person simply goes blind, doesn't change anything, just keeps on doing what they're doing and not realize that they're gonna suffer the consequences. You know, much like investing. You know, people that I know that invest every day, they're looking at their portfolio. They're looking and seeing the changes. You know, even today with all the change of power, don't think for a moment that the market is going to be doing some weird stuff. So those that are heavily in the market or those that are just trying to discern what they need to do, they're paying attention and they're going to respond. Think about it in your marriage. You're going to see, if you're not paying attention to your marriage, you could find yourself going down a dead-end road. And so then as you begin to do your marriage, you begin to take, as a wise person, as a wise wife or a wise husband, you begin to see some telltale signs. You begin to see things and things that make your marriage healthy or make it unhealthy. And you take precautions. You begin to change things because you're paying attention. I think that's the whole thing behind a wise person, is that you're paying attention and you're discerning the situation. And if it's dangerous, you're going to take the precautions. You're going to begin to deviate. You're going to begin to do things that you need to do to change that course so you don't suffer the consequences. But the simpleton, Solomon says, will just continue to go do what they're doing. And so oftentimes, and I think that, you know, specifically in marriage, that a married couple will continue to do the same thing over and over and over and over and over again. And they're trying to figure out why we got where we were. And they're not paying attention to the signs that that were in their marriage of unhealthiness. So I think it's really, really important for us to realize that to take this nugget and put it in our life is to really pay attention and be wise. If things aren't happening, you've got to figure out why they're not happening. You know, if your home is in disarray, if your home is chaotic, if it's your home's not a place of peace, you know, a wise person will take an evaluation and figure out why is it that way. And then they take the precautions, or they begin to figure out, okay, this isn't healthy or that's not healthy. And so now we're going to begin to change that, take that out. If my relationships at my job are not healthy, what do I need? Or maybe if we're seeing a change and we might hear that I might be losing my job or being laid off, okay, what am I going to do? I'm just going to continue to spend the way I've been spending? No. You begin to sit there and say, okay, we need to make sure we put some money in the savings. We need to make sure that we're not spending frivolously. Maybe it's time to eat at home more than out at In-N-Out. But you begin to take precautions. Even in the midst of this pandemic, a foolish person would just simply keep on doing what they're doing and say, you know what, it's not going to affect me. My friends, you know how many people that have suffered the consequences because they didn't take the precautions? And it doesn't mean you stop life. I don't believe for a moment that you stop life, but you've got to deal with the things that come into your life and deal with them in a wise way so you don't suffer the consequences. And unfortunately, too many people have suffered the consequences because they just didn't take the precautions out of wisdom. And so let me encourage you today as we face this new presidency, as we face life in the pandemic, as you face just your own life in marriage and family and children and whatever, that you take the precautions and you look and you see, just like Solomon says, that a prudent person, a wise person, foresees the danger and they take precautions. Don't be that simple person that continues to go blindly, think it won't affect you. And unfortunately, you would suffer the consequences. So be encouraged today. God is with you and he'll give you the wisdom that you need. And all you need to do is ask him, say, Lord, I got this difficult situation in my life. Help me figure out how to make the changes in my life. My marriage is struggling. Lord, help me to figure out what needs going on. I see this. I see that. Okay, Lord, help. How do I change that? How do I begin to maneuver through that? And so that we won't fall off a bridge. And so when you do that, God's going to give you the wisdom from on high to help you. So you don't have to lean on your own wisdom. You can lean on God's wisdom. Amen? Amen. Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you today for your many blessings, God. And I just thank you because we know that our trust is in you. And Father, we want to be wise people, Lord God. And Lord, in this world of difficulties and challenges, Lord God, life's ever changing. There's so much uncertainty. But Lord, we serve a God that is certain. And with that means that is the closer that I'm connected to certainty, the more and more that I'm going to be able to deal with life and make good decisions based on your truth. And so, Father, I pray for everyone that is watching today that, God, that they would be pertinent people, Lord God, that they would seek you and find that wisdom that they need so that they don't crash or they don't fall off a bridge, but Lord God, they will live a life and life more abundantly as they make those decision changes in their life. And Lord, we pray that you would just continue to help us navigate through everything, God. And we pray today as we start our day and in just a few moments, Lord God, in this new day that we're going to put in a new president of the United States. Father, we pray right now. You told us in your word to pray for those that are in leadership and kings, Lord God. So we lift up our new president before you. God, we pray that you would minister to him and his family, Lord. Keep them safe, his cabinet. Father, we pray that even as they start their day, even in this moment of time, God, they are finding themselves in church. And Lord, I pray that it would not be just a symbolic gesture and just, again, carrying the label of Christian, but Lord God, that they would truly seek your wisdom, God, and your divine intervention. Father, we pray that they would get a word from on high and begin to lead this nation, God, and this nation would prosper when they put you first in their life and in the life of our government. And so, Father, we know we live in these uncertain times and so much division and so much hatred and so much ungodliness in government as well as in our nation. Father, we pray that you would heal our nation. But as your word declares today, a prudent person, the wise person, the Bidens and the Harris, Lord God, we pray that they would be a wise person and they would foresee the dangers that are lurking in our country. And then they would take the precautions, and Lord, they would look to you and lean in on you, Lord God, that you could help them and guide them as they make the decisions for our nation, Father. May this nation truly come back to what this moment of 7:14 was all about, that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from their evil ways, you said that you would hear from heaven and forgive us of our sins and heal our land, Lord God. That's what we need. So, Father, may we as a nation turn our hearts back to you, and that you would soften our hearts, Lord God, and we would draw closer to you so that we would not have to suffer the consequences of a simpleton. And so, Father, we praise you and we thank you for this day. Bless your people, God. Give them a great day today, I pray. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Amen. God bless you today. I hope you're going to be a wise person today. Be wise. Be wise. A good thing, don't text and drive. Amen. Amen. God bless you. If you can join us, we start our new Bible study series tonight. It's going to be Unfiltered Jesus. It's filmed in the homeland. It's a great series. I'm looking so forward to it. I've already prefaced it. It is some good teaching. And so we're going to have a great time. We're going to laugh tonight. We're going to pray tonight. And we're going to study God's word tonight. Amen. So God bless you. Have a great day today. And I'll see you tonight. And if not, I'll see you tomorrow morning. 7:14 prayer. Blessings to you. Take care.